The member for Vancouver West End.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Well, I'm proud to stand today to invite you all to one of the biggest protests. In fact, it is the biggest protest in BC. It's been going for 37 years. It's 12 days away, and people hold signs, they shout, maybe they dance, maybe they smile, maybe they sing. I speak, of course, of the Vancouver Pride Parade. It's also, of course, not just a protest, but a celebration. It's a protest against inequality, it's a protest against hatred, and it's a protest against those that seek to put others down for being who they are. It's a celebration of how far we've come. It's a celebration of equality. It's a celebration of justice. I'd like to thank the Vancouver Pride Society for helping shepherd this incredible protest celebration for so many years. Now, they say it's been 37 years. There's a lot of debate even about that point because, of course, there were rallies and protests in the 70s, in the 60s, even into the 50s. But the parade itself has been going for 37 years, or so we're told. In the early days, politicians wouldn't be seen at such a thing. No, it was people having to put paper bags over their faces because their employers would fire them. They would end up in jail. They would have media find their homes, target them, and shame them. But you know, they soldiered on. They continued. First it was gay liberation. Then it became gay pride. Now it's just pride. Why is that, Honourable Speaker? Because we acknowledge that transgender people face difficulties, lesbian people face difficulties, bisexuals and gay men as well all face challenges, but we also face incredible opportunities of love and unity. That's what pride is about. So there's picnics, prayers, tea dances, runs, breakfasts, barbecues, lectures, and calls for action on transgender rights. I'd like to invite you all. I hope you'll be there this Sunday, April 2nd. Have a great day, Honourable Speaker. August 2nd. Thank you.